you will notice them. And if you don't take quick remedial action at the time, of course, at the end of the day, you have a failure staring you on the face. Inaction by those who are in positions to stop these things. Environmental influences, I've said that, corruption in the wider society. How would all it have been different? Yesterday, somebody sent me a post about a degree is now being offered at a university to study about corruption in Nigeria. A degree is being offered now to study about it. And I recriminated to the person who sent it to me that my worry is that the graduates of that school may not have employment. Because corrupt employers of labor, will you guys take somebody who study how to stop corruption? So that's my worry about that. Otherwise, it's a good one if we can learn from what we are seeing there. So we're saying, beyond all these blame games, right, the directors was in the auditor, let's look quickly at the characteristics of a winning organization. I had the managing director in the Orient Bank then, my MT. He is always singing it as a swan song. In every winning organization, everybody is a winner. In every losing organization, everybody loses out. That is true of unity. For those who will want to blame a particular people, you will lose out when UNICEF loses out. You will be a winner when UNICEF is winning. That is the truth of life. And that is the motivation for us to put in our best wherever we find ourselves. Moving an organization towards excellence improves tremendously competitiveness in an ever-changing marketplace. It requires discipline and commitment. There's this Professor Graham who tried to outline some of the characteristics of a winning organization. As I read them, please put it in line with what we're having at UNICEF and see whether we're measuring up. Winning organizations do what they say. They announce what they plan to do, and they meet the plans and the budgets. To do this, they have clear processes, good control systems. We are talking about control systems. I know we have quality control system here. People who take personal responsibility for their work, they don't shift blames. They take personal responsibility for their work and rigorously measure performance and learn from their mistakes. We must begin to learn to measure performance in this university. And begin to apportion remuneration and the penalty for bad performance and good performance. It's only thing that the vision is there now, 200 universities in the world. We are not going to get there by magic. We are going to get there by seeing these characteristics of a good organization. True leadership and focused efforts are key to becoming a winning company. Effective execution, this enables the organization to deliver the results that they have and they say they will, okay? So effective execution, adapting rapidly. You must adapt to the changing situation. That's why when they talked about our digital university. Getting the right people to do the right things will give us the leverage we are looking for. Then, of course, Gandhi talked about the customer. The customer, the key, our customers, the students. My heart bleeds. I have been here for 22 years. The way we treat our students leaves much to be desired. And I begin to ask myself, if they were my children, would I treat them that way? Will I treat them that way? Doesn't it appeal to our consciences? These are future generations. Let me tell you that this lecture that I have been put up here, I didn't spend a couple. And I let the also in the baguette give me some gifts. I didn't spend a couple. My students, onion, over 5 kobo. What have I done? I didn't do anything. I was just doing my duty. Who said that the reward of the lecturer is in heaven? It's also here. I'm a living example. So let's, they are our kids and we must respect them. The Vice Chancellor has now instituted quality control measures and he said that our students will also be part of the assessment of our staff for promotion. And somebody cynically made to me and said, this thing will not work in Nigeria. It's left for us to know whether it will work or not. I asked men to allow it to work. And you see everybody will sit up. We did a small research here about accountancy students and how lecture and all that. And we had terrible rebellion. Some of the students said they left accountancy totally because of the quality of delivery of some of our lecturers. Thank God they are very good lecturers here. Thank God. But the truth is that the system at times doesn't even recognize those who are people. We recognize only those who are lobbyists. It has come to a stage. I didn't write that one because I don't want it in print. Some now go to call their egos to become heads of the bandits. Is it true or not? A shame. It's a shame. And such people never do well, I said, you can vote me. So now let's give university an agenda for winning sustainability. One question. I said I won't waste your time. Deriving from our earlier discussions, the stakeholders of Nnamdi's university include the governing council, both internal and external members, the top management team led by the vice chancellor, the various schools and colleges with their management, the bursary, the registry, the internal audit, directorate, the students' affairs, budget and monitoring, the students themselves, the academic union, and whatever. And the various departments and faculties, the non-teaching staff. The rote in the system is not only limited to academic staff. At times I hear rumblings that if you want to get a transcript, money will change hands. And I say, my own university, to give a student their transcript, you take money from that person. That money is an accursed money. So we are looking for an excellent system. The university system is thus a very complex one, and it's the ability of the management to wield these groups together for common purpose that makes for an excellent organization. The present administration of the university has clearly articulated its vision and mission. It has made a bold statement, for example, to the effect that the university should be among the first 200 universities across the globe. Best 200 universities. A winning organization treats its customers as kings, and the reason for their existence. In the case of UNICEF, despite the actions of the present administration, some lecturers still see their students as avenue for augmenting their salaries. This is the basis for the unwholesome relationship between some lecturers and their students. One thing from my own 22 years of experience here, and in fact, I have taught for 40 years, part on part-time basis. I started as a part-time lecturer in 1981. One thing about students, once they know that you are not going to tolerate any nonsense, they will start reading. They say, this man, let's go and read his book. You will fail also if we don't read. But if you give them opportunities to come and search you, there were the same people who would go and tell that man is useless and hopeless. Reputation is involved there. So quality control monitors, please make sure we also monitor the quality of teaching in this great university. It's very, very important. I've talked about apathy in departmental affairs, especially by the senior members of the departments. There's apathy. I don't know what, let me also use this example, it is time to say this. The new administration is trying to have a policy on who and who becomes a departmental head and at what time. At other universities, at the Nnamdi campus, for example, the next head of the department is already known based on seniority, unless that person has a criminal or a disciplinary matter. That one is different. Other universities, what they do is to elect. So at least on basis of popularity. So you don't go and force somebody because of a ethnic and other based primordial considerations. Vice Chancellor has started it. I believe it will now become a norm so that everybody knows when you are going to be HOD. And all this nonsense lobbying will stop. I am rounding up. Concluding thoughts. Organizations fail or succeed for many reasons. Our discourse has shown that corporate scandals and failures happen because of many factors, the chief of which is poor management and poor corporate governance. Many corporates are responsible because of their actions or inactions. Top management tops the list and they have to rein in themselves if their organizations must move forward. This profession, which I'm proud to belong to, is a highly disciplined, it's a highly regulated profession, highly ethical. But we have our bad eggs as well. So there are many corporate villains in this game. The real question then is, how do we prevent corporate scandals and failures, abomination? We have, therefore, also sketched this top-winning organization and noted that a lot is being done under the present administration. However, ample room remains for improvement. In every winning organization, everybody is a winner. It's my pet, this is from my former MD. Why in every organization, be it church, be it the family, be it the university, everybody comes out a loser? Building an excellent organization, therefore, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, is a collective effort. I thank you for your attention. And to go and be on the board.
Standing ovation for the Professor Sunday Tukunebu Okaro. Thank you very much.
That's okay. Please, I want to use this occasion to thank. Please, we can sit down to thank. I don't know how to begin to thank. The distinguished Vice Chancellor will have been here personally because I was in contact with him. But there's this emergency. Today is the, I think he's in Abuja now because of governing council. I don't know whether the crisis here and emergency meeting has started, but the governing council is being inaugurated today in Abuja. So he's unavoidably absent. Otherwise, he would have been here. I would have started with the God Almighty who made this thing possible for me today. I have said, so a short man can be celebrated. So a great head man can be celebrated. I didn't know this. I didn't know at all. Oh, here am I standing. Standing. And my promise, I have promised God that I will be his for the rest of my life. Try to draw attention to others. That's a God in heaven that sustains us. I don't have money, but I don't lack.
Yes.
I said I have a modest house. I don't know how I built it. I don't know. But I depend on a God that is faithful, that will always give you what you want at you. We used to be tenants and we didn't know we will ever be there. Suddenly God said, now you are about to die. Our God is faithful. Our God is faithful all the time. I've turned the Vice Chancellor. He was the first person to appoint me. I'm still a deputy director now. Is it correct? Until I finish this lecture. I'm deputy director. I'm still midnight. So I will still take the deputy director position till midnight. The same thing with director of our cooperative. Till midnight, I'm still a director there. God has been kind to me. Some of us don't. You see, I'm self-effacing. I don't. If we recognize you, if it is correct, I'll be saying that I said, look, we need this man as deputy. He's a strategic directorate. Budget and project manager. And my brother was appointed as my head, and I was a deputy. And we were teasing ourselves and joking. I said, well, since we're coming from the same hometown, we might as well be holding the meetings at Ogili and then communicate to the members of staff what we have decided to do. So we thank God for him, the Sibonde. Yeah, the digital thing. I think, okay, she's here. I want you to be here when I'm saying this. Some of you, during the last election, I was the person that nominated Professor Chukwuemeka. He's here. Chukwuemeka is here, yes. I nominated him. You know what happened? Few days before the election, the dean called me and said, look, I'm coming out for the election. And I said, wow, I have already committed myself to this young man. I don't want to play double. Why didn't you tell me earlier now so that I can consider the two persons? Dean, I'm very sorry. I won't support you. Before the election proper, we met again somewhere. And the dean said, okay, I respect your feelings. Let's reach an agreement. Is it true or what? Let's reach an agreement. Anybody that wins, promise me that you will support that person. I said, Carrie, go. I will do that. She swept the polls. I started calling for her meetings and so on. She could have single-handedly aborted this, what we are doing today. And she kept her own part of the beginning. And I feel happy for the young generation. I feel happy that we have somebody that is principled that can take this place to a greater height. And that's my happiness. That's my happiness. Some would have started having both faith for you. And if they say validation, they say for who? For who? but she didn't do that. So I thank you, my team, for what you're doing. God will continue. So that's the planning committee, the lecture series. When my time came to go, there was palpable silence. And I said, can I live through the battle? So I'm going to live through the battle. I picked my phone and called Professor Ibeta. I said, Prof, I'm going on the 15th of July. And he said, congratulations, what do you want for us, from us? And I said, you are the chairman of the Valedictory, this lecture said, can I have a slot? You know what Ibeta said? Regard it as a done. I knew that they faced a lot of challenges for quarters I didn't expect. But it's too solid, Professor Basil, Mongolia, and others, they said no. It was happen. And that is why we're here. I thank them very, very much. The planning committee there, we're all running around trying to get things together. I won't forget the PhD class. I just taught them for 1 month. Before this thing, they came and said they wanted to see me and gave me a wonderful gift. I won't disclose the gift because I don't want to share it with anybody. The same thing with the Directorate of Budget and the Project Monitor. They surprised me, gave me a wonderful gift. My students said they must be here today. And thank God, many of them are here. My listen to you is continue to use your Uche, because accountancy is about Uche. I can remember, I have not forgotten you. You are my immediate constituency. Accountancy profession, especially the profession, gave me the solid background that I needed. The other members, I salute you. You know what was somebody for us here? It's good to be a Christian. There was no discrimination. We were all members of the same family. SWAT members, one of us, are you here now? Our God. They are here in their numbers, and they, on their own, also organized wonderful things for me. May God bless you upon them. Of course, my siblings. You see, some people say, Okaro, you don't fight for anything. And I said, we were not brought up to fight. We were brought up to be our brother's keepers. So I can't fight. I didn't imbibe it. And when people begin to fight, I feel odd and all that. So my siblings, I thank you. Thank you all. Mabel, Ndoka, Joy, and others. I'm very happy that some of you are here. They're my immediate family, of course. And my in-laws, my grandchildren, I respect you and cherish you. My students, I have also talked about you. They are my friends, some of them came from anywhere, and so on. I'm saying thank you for being there for me. Thank you, thank you. I hope I'm not forgetting some. So what I have said here, the students, the budget committee, ASU gave me a platform. You know why I joined ASU? I will use that as a closing I'm not a union person, actually. And I was the principal manager in my bank, and we were negotiating with labor. But when I came here, one of the vice chancellors, one day threatened me and said he would sack me. What did Okaro do? I raised a voice and they protested. They were castigating the department. It was an exit interview by our NUC, ICANN people. So an exit interview, they pointed out certain things, and then VC took it upon us. At the end of the day, he said, has anybody anything to say? I said, Mr. Vice Chancellor, please. It's not as that. We're working very hard. And we're short-staffed and all that. And the man looked at me and said, Who asked you to say so? He was the same person who said we should air our views. He said, who asked you to say that? And then he turned around and said, Professor Okoye, are you here, Pius? He asked Pius, is this man a part time or full time? And Pius said, full time. He shook his head and said, God has saved me. So I would have lost my job. I went to union and joined the union. I wanted to protect my job. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, thank you very, very much for being there for me. And thank you everybody. Those I mentioned and I mentioned. God in his infinite mercy will reward us. Thank you.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I think I need to clear your indulgence to inform you that this is a tripartite occasion. This is, first of all, valedictory lecture of our old professor, Son Okaro. Of course, today is just marks the his last day in active public service. This after today, he is retiring. So he's at the age of 70. And lastly, today is his birthday. So I think he has many things to celebrate. So of course, in a short while, we'll be cutting his birthday cake here as well. So it's a tripartite occasion. Meanwhile, the chairman has requested that Professor O.C. Agolu from University of Nigeria Enugu campus to please join him in the high table. Professor Agolu, please come up to the high table. While the lecture was going on, Professor Peter Nnamdi, former council member, also stepped in. Professor Peter Nnamdi. And of course, former Dean of Deans. Former Dean of Faculty of Agriculture. Many former. Thank you, sir. You're welcome, sir. And of course, we have a Professor Philomena Ibokwe here with us, Dean, School of Postgraduate Studies, who is represented by the Professor Frank Wampo, HOD, same department. Of course, we have Professor Mathis Moore, who stepped in. Mathis Moore is a Professor of Department of Public Administration. We have Mr. Arinze Obase, he's also here with us. Ladies and gentlemen, without wasting much of our time, let me quickly give just 2 minutes as requested by the lecturer of today, to the managing partner of SWOT, Mr. Alex Mwabozo, for his remarks. It will be a short remarks, just to greet us and to encourage us and to talk. Mr. Alex Mwabozo, an applause for him as he comes up. Let the cake be set. Very soon we will come to the cake. Please don't miss that occasion.
The Vice Chancellor of this institution, the Dean of the Faculty of Management Sciences, Heads of Academic Departments, ladies and gentlemen, I am happy and excited to be here, and I give that excitement and happiness back to Professor Carroll because he made it possible. I represent SWOT, SWOT and Associates based in Enugu. SWOT here is not of strength, weakness, opportunities, and threats, but of success without tears. We are an educational institution that specializes in teaching. Incidentally, when the birth of this school was given, Professor S. C. Okaro, who is being sent up today, was a founding member. The school has made it marks. We are not only the recognized training center for ACCA in East, we are also a recognized training center for ICAM. When we heard of this quotation, it was relayed to the alumni of the school, and they felt that they must be fully represented and mandated me to come here to say thank you to Professor Okaro for all he has done for us. Mr. Okaro is a man I am proud to be associated with. I remember when I was at a very low end of my life, he picked me up. When I was losing confidence in myself, he inspired me and made me what I am today. He not only teach me academically, but he taught me the fear of God. He's a man who refused to go along with people who wants to get rich quick to losing his job. He lost his job as a senior officer of SEO Limited, Asaba, simply because he cannot work with the unbelief. Professor Okaro, we are happy to be associated with you. May God continue to inspire you and help you. You are retiring from active service. You are not retiring from the work of God. You should continue, and God will strengthen you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. The manager partner's word. So in a short while, we'll have a cake here. Very pleased to recognize Mr. Tupemeko Oriako, FCA. He's the chairman of ICAM, Awka, and District Society. He's here with us. Welcome, sir. Please, we have the cake, birthday cake. May I call on the celebrant to please step forward and the wife, immediate family, Sam, and then to please join your brother, immediate family and their spouses, please, even children. It's today a family affair. May I also request that the chairman of education also join? Did you know the fact on the so please join the effect of the game to witness how it's been across? May I also invite the chairman of lecture series, the chairman of local organizing committee, Professor Nico, to also join? Hello, Professor, what are you coming from? Also, I know you have a shock. Let's go with this. Meanwhile, the registrar just stepped in, who is represented, the university registrar, who is represented by Mrs. Blessing Ezafro, a deputy registrar. You're welcome. I also call on Professor Isimman Namife to also see how the game is being taught. It's a great occasion to be 70, it's not 60, it's not 50, it's not 40. Of course, Mrs. Joy at the other end, we especially recognize you, the former registrar of this great institution. We didn't have the faculty. She just stepped out. She has several things here. Please make a space for her. She's our host. Okay, now we assess. Jean is here, the servant is here, the wife is here. Are we safe? Please let's be watching. 70 is not permanent. So as we spell Jesus, because I know the Prof is about to get inside the plateau, there is no other name you want to hear apart from the name of Jesus. So as we spell Jesus, we will draw the game. J E S U S Jesus. Congratulations, Professor Son Okaro, my attendant of the age of 70, on your early retirement from the university. We celebrate you, sir. May God continue to strengthen you. May you continue to shine. May you continue to live and live healthy. Thank you. You shall see your children too.
Happy birthday.
Oh, yes.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
May God bless someone in happy.
Happy birthday.
The servant is seated. Please, we don't have that much distance with us. Time for us to shower things to him. If you have anything for the celebrant, him and the wife, they are seated now. As organizations, individuals, who want to greet, who want to say hello to the celebrant. We take the time. Please, don't be in a hurry to go. After this corporate lecture, we have entertainment. We are fully prepared. Please don't be quick to go. Don't be quick to go. We have something to offer to everyone here. May I inform the members of the high table that immediately after this program, you will be entertained at the dean's office. We are going in the dean's office for your entertainment, members of the high table. Members of staff, please, we are to remain here for your refreshment. One after the other, one after the other.
Everybody sing, everybody sing. You just send me one moment. Come on, come on.
The presentation is ongoing. Let the pastor marry me.
Hello, Prof. Prof. Okaro. Please, as I said before, I was sent by SWAT and associates. And the envelope I've just handed over to you there contained the receipt of the gift item which they bought for you. The gift item is literally is to be delivered from our Latina, you know, Awka here. We're waiting for them. As soon as they come, we can describe this for you. Thank you. On behalf of the friends of Okaro, on behalf of your colleagues, on behalf of the planning committee, on behalf of the members of faculty lecture series committee, heavily led by Professor Ibeza, we jointly present this gift of a deep freezer to you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you very, very much, Swartz and others that have celebrated us. I thought yours by coming here was enough for me, but God has not finished with me. So I won't reject it. May God continue to recognize you, all of you, wonderful, in Jesus' name.
More gifts are still coming. God is not done with us celebrating, so we will keep accepting. We have the people this last year present. Welcome you. Please, immediately after the closing prayer. And all of the for me, why the professor is going on? Ladies and gentlemen, may I respectfully call on our accounting pundit, the chairman of the organizing committee, Professor Patrick Ebunike, for both of thanks.
Chairman of the occasion, our very, very revered and respected celebrants, professors, their presidents, and the head of Mamba, I simply want to stand on behalf of Professor S.C. Okaro Retirement Celebrations Committee to immensely express our profound happiness at your presence. All that I've been saying about Okaro, who is really with us, we appreciate him, we know him and all that. And let me thank our dean, who has collaborated so well, who has been in touch with us throughout the ceremony, and we're able to make this day a reality. The digital dean of the faculty, a human dynamo, a committed, dedicated dean of this faculty, who in love and brotherhood has been able to gather us together. And also, let me also thank the chairman, Valedictory and Lecture Series, Professor Benta. Professor Benta in his usual highly organized manner and character was able to get us together and has put all that you see today, and today we are all celebrating. We thank you and appreciate you, sir. And I won't be in a hurry to forget the chairman of the occasion. A former rector for Okaro, a highly organized man, an academic courses. We all respect him. I remember when some of us were doing our PhDs, his expressions and comments and criticisms were highly honored. We highly appreciated. He made most of these works to look like a dirty work. We thank you, sir. And for today, you are able and organized manner of organizing of events also gives us happiness. We will look forward to thank you so much. Thank you very much. And finally, very, very finally, because today's event actually sparked off from a few friends and associates of Okaro. Professor P.C. Mangwa is with us, and Okaro Kafo. Professor Promise, Dr. Promise Opera, Dr. Chito, and Helene and Azongo, and then again, so many of us who are the committee, we had several meetings, day and night, with all correspondences and all that we see in the WhatsApp. Friends and associates of Okaro rallied around. And we're able to put to muster some few funds that we are happy that today is being made. So we get quite close also enough. Your presence alone makes us happy, and we are happy and also very thankful for your presence. I also have to say congratulations to Okaro. Okaro is the second in the series of this celebration. And his own is unique because it stands out as the first lecture series, lecture of the faculty. So you can see how it is. We will improve from here, and we want to say congratulations, sir. You are not yet tired. I know you know very well. You are not yet tired. I know we will extend and move further in other frontiers and all that. The chicken, we are all here to recognize you and make sure it becomes the next Dangote. Thank you, sir.
We recognize UDC FM who is also covering this event. We thank members of the press who are also here. We thank everybody for making it a day for our celebrant, Professor Sunday Chukwudu Okaro. And we wish that we live to see many other collaborative lectures from this faculty, one of the greatest, if not the greatest, in the university. So, ladies and gentlemen, on this note, I'm aware that some of us are already eating. However, we started with prayer and we end with prayers. And so I call on Reverend Lona Awuzuliwo for the closing benediction.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Please let us stand to prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We give you praise and glory for the life and services of our brother Sunday Okaro, who you have used wonderfully. Lord, there are testimonies as to what you have done in him and with him among men in our generation. We give you thanks. We thank you for his life. We thank you for his family. We thank you for his faith. And we commit him to you, Heavenly Father, that what you began to do in him continue until the day is done. Father, our society is terribly corrupt, and we need auditors who will do a good job. But we have also seen that there are several of us who have stake in the matter of turning our society around. Help us. Help us. Help us. Our brother has prophesied this day and has shown us what is wrong with us. And Lord, we want solution. Help us to be courageous enough to stand by the truth, to lead lives of integrity, and to oppose evil head on until it is wiped out. We are looking up to you for heaven, for mercy. As we go from here, we pray that you continue with us. Continue with Okaro. Father, he is not old yet. There is still so much in him that you will use to serve society. We pray that you spare him and spare his